Praise the Lord, and it's a great day to live. We continue on broadcasting this Bible study on the air through the medium of television, through the facilities of Trinity Broadcasting Network. And it is very important to use whatever instrument that we can use of so that the message of the greatness of God will be delivered. In the mighty precious name of Jesus, I will start this message with a title, 2014 is the year of God's glory, Jesus Christ. So Jesus Christ is the very one who will work the works of God. And it is through Christians that this work will be demonstrated so that people will see the glory of the Lord. So before I continue, let us start it with prayer. Father God, we thank you so much that it is you who are using these mouths. So let your word pass through these mouths, and by the power of your spirit, let everyone understand. And let the seven function of the Holy Spirit work mightily in each one's lives. Let there be conviction, and let there be a mighty influence of your spirit in the lives of many people. And receive all the praise and the honor and the glory in Jesus Christ's name. Amen. Let me start this message with a warning. In Hebrews 13, verse 9. Hebrews 13, verse 9. And I desire that a mighty move of the Spirit will be given a wonderful and prestigious praise and honor, because it will always be the Holy Spirit. Be not carried about with diverse and strange doctrines, for in it a good thing that the heart be established with grace, and not with meats which have not profited them that have been occupied therein. So the heart must be established with grace. In simple word, it has to be grace all the way through, so that everyone will benefit from the teaching of the word. Year of God's glory, it's not only 2014, and I don't confine his glory on a given year, because the glory of the Lord is forever. It is everlasting. But I made this 2014 declaration of the year of God's glory, that is Jesus Christ, to make an emphasis. So emphasizing something that Jesus will be doing and is doing even at this present time. So the glory means the presence. The glory means the mighty power of God at work. And there are at least 8 guidelines that I desire to to share to all of us. Because Jesus Christ is the only supreme, absolute, ultimate remedy for all mankind. The first thing that I would like to share to us is the truth that all have sinned and must be saved. No one is without sin pertaining to this inherited sin from Eden, which was first committed by Adam. But before I continue, I desire that everyone understand that it is only Jesus who is the remedy for mankind in whatever they are situated or in whatever circumstance that they may be experiencing. So salvation is essential. And God's glory will take place once everyone start to believe that they need salvation. All have sinned and everyone need salvation. In Romans 3:23, to make this clear, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. All have sinned and come short of the glory of God. And the particular word, all, everyone included. No one excepted and no one. It's only Jesus that never committed sin. But every human being have sinned. Not because they desire it, but because humankind inherited the sin that has been committed by Adam in Eden. So that is a sin that every human being received. And because this is truth, everyone need to free himself from this sinful nature. No one can free himself by his own way of freeing himself, because there is only one way to save a person and for the salvation of everyone. There is only one way. And it is Jesus. No other way, no other person, but only Jesus. In John 14, verse 6, Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. So salvation is essential for every man, for all human being. Everyone must be saved. And salvation is only through Jesus Christ. No other way, no other means. It is only Jesus Christ. In Acts 4:12, it is very clear, and this is truth. Neither is there salvation in any other, for there is none other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. So salvation is through a name. And that name is not to be given by any man, but that name must be given from heaven. Neither is there salvation in any other. Religion will implement another way by which a person will be saved. But heaven declared that there is only one way to be saved, and there is only one Savior. One way to be saved and one Savior. There is no other name. Because Jesus is the name above all names. Neither is there salvation in any other. For there is none other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. The word "we" include all of us. The one who declared this, and including me and including you. So all of us must be saved. And the way for the salvation of everyone is only by a given name.
Hello, partners and friends. Thank you for your support for this ministry. Without your generous support, we will not be able to air the gospel of Jesus on radio and television. And as an act of appreciation for your love gift of 1,000 pesos this month, we will send you a Great Day to Live watch right at the very doorstep of your house. Thank you very much. And remember, he who wins soul is wise. God bless you and keep on partnering, and let us together advance the kingdom of God. Great news! You can listen to Brother Greg Durante at DWAB 1098 kHz AM band whether you are on the go or stuck in the traffic in Metro Manila, in Calabarzon area, Mindoro, and Cavite, and nearby provinces in Luzon. You can be encouraged and keep on listening on the gospel of Jesus Christ, and be encouraged every Monday to Friday, 6:30 in the morning and 10 o'clock in the evening. We praise God and we thank you so much, dear friends and partners, for supporting us that we will be able to deliver and share the goodness of the Lord from the Women's Correctional Institute and to all the people we have shared the free hamburger in the road street of Binyan, Laguna. Again, never stop helping, never stop donating, never stop participating. God is so good and He sees your effort. And that's why God will bless you exceedingly abundantly above what you expect. Again, partners, we cannot do this alone. But thanks for now, and thank you very much for doing your share in the kingdom of God.
Only by and through a given name. In Philippians chapter 2, verse 9. Wherefore God also hath highly exalted him and given him a name which is above every name. So there are numerous names you can speak of, as long as you can remember of names of people, of names of heroes. But there is only one name that is above every name. So name all the names that you can remember. Write every name that you can write. But above all those you can remember and can be written, the only name that is above all names is Jesus. So Jesus is the only name. And in verse 10, that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow. Again, the name is once again written here. That at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow of things in heaven and things in earth and things under the earth. So the finality of this truth that there is only one Savior, that every human being must be saved, and the only way to be saved is only by one name that is given from heaven. And this name, every knee should bow. At the name of Jesus, every knee should bow of things in heaven and things in earth and things under the earth. So the things under the earth is hell. So even those that are in hell, they are supposed to bow down to the name of Jesus. And in verse 11, and that every tongue, so every knee, every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. God is honored, the Father is honored, the glory of God the Father. So the Father is honored when we confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. So it is very important that our mouth will be in line with the Word. And the Word says that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. So when we confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, the Father is glorified. So the Father is receiving glory. The Father is receiving honor. The Father is delighted to hear that every tongue is speaking that Jesus Christ is Lord. And in verse 12, "Wherefore, my beloved, as you have always obeyed, not as in my presence only, but now much more in my absence, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling." First, salvation is a gift. So when you receive salvation, it is inside. Because the moment that we surrender our life and receive Jesus as our Lord, our spirit is resurrected. Because of the sin of Adam, our spirit is dead, and that deadness separates us from God. The moment that Jesus become our Lord, then our spirit lives, and our spirit is the only part of our being that can communicate, that can have a conversation with the Father, with the Son, and with the Holy Spirit. Now, salvation is a must. I was saved in 1977, November 26. Since that time, I do not stop telling people of their need of salvation. So I am working out my salvation. I am working out my salvation with fear and trembling. Fear means that I am so eager, I am so zealous, I am so passionate to work out my salvation, to produce the work that is a result and an effect of that salvation. In Ephesians 2:8, this is how salvation came into a life. "For by grace are you saved through faith, and that not of yourselves, it is the gift of God." Again, let us analyze this one verse with three praises. "For by grace are you saved through faith." So this is a complete praise. "And that not of yourselves, it is the gift of God." Most particularly, let us be reminded that it is not our work that saves us. It is not our goodness that saves us. It is the grace of God that saves us. And that grace can only be appropriated by faith. And faith is also a gift. So when I receive that grace, I am able to surrender my life. So the grace is at work in the life of the sinner the moment that he believed Jesus. So grace works so that by my faith, I receive my salvation. It is the work of God. So grace, faith, and my salvation are gifts. I cannot think of any other way but always to thank God because I have done nothing for me to be saved. And in verse 9, not of works, lest any man should boast. So here, it has to be noted that no man should boast. And what is boasting? Boasting is declaring that by himself a man is saved. No. It is not the work of men that salvation occurred into a life of a person. No, it is only the sole work of God by grace through faith. And in verse 10, for we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus unto good works, which God hath before ordained that we should walk in them. So the working out of our salvation is through the ordained good works. So we shall be seen by people. So people will see us that we receive the salvation because we are doing the good works. And that good works has been ordained. So even before we were saved, that work is already planned. And the moment that we were saved, then that work, that good works, we shall do it willingly with sincerity. We were saved. So if you receive Jesus as your Lord, you are saved. It's by grace through faith. Now that we understand that all have sinned and must be saved, and the way to salvation is for people to surrender his life and to accept Jesus as his personal Lord. And the good thing, the second truth, is that God desires that no one shall perish. Let us be reminded of the good heart of God. He does not want that any should perish. So by working out that salvation that I receive, that you ought also to work that salvation out so that others will be saved. Jesus portrayed a good life of obedience. He is obedient unto the point of death by crucifixion on that cross. So our salvation has to be proven. Our salvation has to show that wonderful result of that salvation. God's goodness is that he doesn't want that any should perish. In 2 Peter 3:9, this is the good heart of God. The Lord is not slack concerning his promise, as some men count slackness, but he is long-suffering to usward, not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. As you are hearing for the first time this preaching and teaching of the word, and for those of you who followed this program for some time or some months, then repentance has to be decided by everyone. And repentance is a change of mind. And a change of mind has to be effected. And the change of mind is to believe that Jesus is the God-given name from heaven, that Jesus is the only Savior and there is none else. Not slack concerning his promise. God is not slow. Though it is more or less 2,000 years ago when he made this promise that he will come back again. So the promise is his coming back again. Jesus promised that He will come back again. And if you are sensitive, and if you are really waiting for His coming, then an alarming situation is rightly being done by all those forces that thought that they don't need God. A new world order is in the air. And there are meetings of big nations, and they are speaking of new world order. And that new world order, if you will only know that the sign of that new world order is to decimate at least 70% of the total population by that time that they institute that new world order. They are not afraid because their desire is an evil intent, so they will kill at least 70% of the population so that only 30% will remain alive, because they thought that the earth is so small for a 7 or 8 billion number of people on the face of the earth. But they don't understand that God is so mighty, that God is so wise and knowledgeable of what He is doing, because God is behind His plan. But because people think of that they are greater than God, and that is the thought of Lucifer, that is the thought of Satan. So we who are saved, we who are baptized in the Spirit, we understand that this is slow, the slow time of the fulfillment of His promise to return. And the very reason and the very intent of God is that none should perish, that everyone should come to repentance. And how shall a person change his mind? A person need to hear the truths of the gospel. A person need to hear that he is lost without Jesus. And the way to deliver the message that everyone have sinned is through the gospel. By broadcasting in all mediums of and facilities of broadcasting in a wide range, and in a wide area, and one of that way is through television, satellite, and website, that everyone will come into repentance. When they hear that they need salvation, when they hear that there is only one name by which a person can be saved, then there will be a change of mind. So a change of mind takes place when someone hears the message. In Romans 10 verse 6, Romans 10, 6. But the righteousness which is of faith speaketh on this wise: say not in thine heart, who shall ascend into heaven? That is to bring Christ down from above. And then verse 7. Or who shall descend into the deep? That is to bring up Christ again from the dead. So these two verses is referring, let us go back to verse 6, but the righteousness which is of faith. So people can only be justified by means of Jesus Christ.
You may write us at Post Office Box 4135, Manila, Philippines. For your prayer request, call or text us at these numbers. We will pray for you that your problems and needs will be answered by God. You may also visit our website at www.gregdurante.com and like us on Facebook and Twitter as well. We invite you to attend our Sunday service at Biyaya ng Diyos Christian Fellowship, second floor, Medicor Building, Ortigas Avenue, Green Hills, San Juan. It's a great day to live. If you are blessed with this program and have the desire to support Greg Durante Ministries to continue on expanding the reach of our TV broadcast, you may deposit your donations to the following accounts listed on your TV screen.
And Jesus Christ is the righteousness of God. So when people receive Jesus as his Lord, then the righteousness of God is in him. And it is only in the righteousness of Jesus that men will be accepted by the Father. And righteousness will come to a person by his and through his mouth, by confessing that Jesus is his Lord. And Jesus, in verse 7, so Jesus was raised up from the dead by the power of the Holy Spirit. And in verse 8, but what sayeth it? The word is nigh thee, even in thy mouth and in thy heart. That is the word of faith which we preach. So here is the way. So the preaching of the word will bring a person to realize that he needs Jesus. He needs salvation. Is the only Savior is Jesus. And the only way to be saved is by grace. It's not of work. It's by grace, the finished work of Jesus on Calvary. So the word of faith which we preach, and in verse 9, this is the way to be saved. That if thou shalt confess with thy mouth, so it is in the confession that we are connecting our life into the word. That if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and shalt believe in thine heart that God hath raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. How shall salvation come into a person's life? When you confess. The word confess is to agree in the truths. So I confess that Jesus is Lord of my life. So I am agreeing in the truths that there is only one Savior, that the name of Jesus is the only name given to every human being by which he shall be saved. So when I speak it through my mouth, that is confession, and I believe in my heart, then salvation is achieved in its entirety and completeness. And in verse 10, for with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. Righteousness, then salvation. So in my heart, I believe that Jesus is Lord, and I am righteous by believing, not by work, but by believing. So when I speak what I believe in my heart, then I am saved. So first, believing in the heart. Second, speaking by the mouth or through the mouth or confessing through the mouth. So this is the way to salvation. A person needs righteousness so that he will be right before God. Salvation, then righteousness. Righteousness, then salvation. So believe first in the heart. Confess with your mouth. The way by which a person is saved, first confess. Right now, if you confess with your mouth. So when you confess, just say, Jesus is Lord of my life. So the heart is not yet believing. But if you confess with your mouth, let us go back again to verse 9 so that you will understand how you will receive salvation. If thou shalt confess with thy mouth, so what is the first thing that you are going to do? To confess first with your mouth. The Lord Jesus. So confess the Lord Jesus. Say with your mouth. Say it. Say it right now. So that salvation will take place in your life. Say that Jesus is Lord. Jesus is Lord. That is confession. And then when you confess with your mouth, then your heart will believe. Your heart will believe that Jesus raised by the power of God from the dead. And in verse 10, it is the reality of the truths. First, confess with your mouth. Second, believe with your heart that Jesus is Lord. So I confess Jesus is Lord. And later I believe in my heart that Jesus is indeed, that Jesus truly is Lord. And that believing in my heart made me to receive righteousness. So I am now robed with righteousness and clothed with the holiness of God. So I am completely saved. Now, with regard to the desire of God that none should perish, so work out your own salvation. So use your salvation to save many people. And in verse 11, for the scripture said, whosoever believeth on him shall not be ashamed. So continue on believing Jesus. No matter what you feel, no matter what your sentiment, no matter what the circumstances are, continue on believing that you are saved. Because natural thing will oppose your new found and new received salvation. But don't bother to be anxious whether you are saved or not. Just believe that you are saved. And the effect of that salvation will take place and you will not be put to shame whatever. And in verse 12, for there is no difference between the Jew and the Greek, for the same Lord over all is rich unto all that call upon him. So the need of every person, all people, whether Jew or Greek, whether Jew or Gentile, the Jews are to be saved, and salvation is only by Jesus. The Greeks, the Gentiles, the pagans, the heathens shall be saved. The atheist, the agnostic must be saved. And for salvation of all, there is only one Lord. So the same Lord will save the Jews. The same Lord shall save the Greek. The same Lord shall save the atheist. The same Lord shall save the pagans. The same Lord shall save the socialists. The same Lord shall save the communists. There is only one Lord by which all classes of people will be saved. And you will not be put to shame. All those who believe Jesus will not be ashamed. It will be goodness for every person to believe, to receive, and to confess that Jesus is Lord. So we have a great task. We have a great mission to go on. And in verse 13, for whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. So call on the name of the Lord and be saved. Glory. Call on the name of the Lord and be saved, so that the glory of the Lord will cover your life every day. And the glory of the Lord is His mighty presence. The glory of the Lord is His capability and ability to do wonders, to do signs, to do miracles in your life. So that those will be an evidence that you are saved and that God is living in you and working with you. And in verse 14, how then shall they call on him in whom they have not believed? And how shall they believe in him of whom they have not heard? And how shall they hear without a preacher? So in your hearing right now, in your television set, you are viewing and you are seeing me declaring to you your need of Jesus Christ, declaring to you that you need salvation. by declaring that you are lost, that you are a sinner, and you need a Savior, then I am preaching. I am proclaiming. I am reaching each person so that by the power of the Spirit of God, they will be convicted. They will be convinced that they need a Savior. And no matter what situation of life you are in, you might be full of vices, you might be a hardcore communist, but if you will call, or you are languishing in jail, and you perhaps is undergoing a terminal disease, in the name of Jesus, just call on the name of Jesus. Whatever your situation is, just call the name of Jesus, and this is preaching. Call the name of Jesus and you shall be saved. That is why God has appointed this moment of time so that you will be hearing the voice of a preacher, and that preacher in verse 14, how then shall they call in him in whom they have not believed? And how shall they believe in him of whom they have not heard? And how shall they hear without a preacher? So, who are you to call? The him that is referred to in the first part of this verse is Jesus Christ. How shall you call on Jesus when you have not heard him preach? And at this very moment, you are listening. That the name of Jesus is your only hope. That Jesus is the only name by which you will be saved. You can save yourself and free yourself from whatever situation that you are in. But most to your hearing, most importantly, know that the inherited sin from Eden, the sin that was committed by Adam, is the main thing that you have to free yourself from. So the moment you call on the name of Jesus, that sinful nature is broken. So shout, Jesus, save me. Shout, Jesus, you are my Lord. And right now, the power of God is mightily working in your life. So you will feel the power of God because a burden has been removed. A chain has been destroyed. The shackle that imprisoned you for so many years has been destroyed. So right now, in the name of Jesus, you are now saved by your declaration of that loudness of your voice. Jesus, Jesus, save me. Jesus, come into my life. Then Jesus came. Now you are free. And in verse 15, and how shall they preach except they be sent? So I am chosen, and I was sent to you. That is why I am in your living room, or that is why I am in whatever you are right now. Maybe you are driving. So I was sent by God to you through this medium of broadcast. How beautiful are the feet of them that preach the gospel of peace and bring glad tidings of good things. Now you are saved. Continue on your salvation. So all have sinned and must be saved, and you declare Jesus as your Lord, then you are saved. And then God decided that through us who were saved, we need to go to many others, our loved ones, our relatives, our friends, our neighbor, our associate in our work. Let us bring to them Jesus Christ so that they too will be saved. In this present time, the third truths that I desire, because I cannot make all the eight truths that I prepared, but the third truth, in this present time, the prophecy of Daniel is taking place. In Daniel 12:4. So I want us, because I will concentrate on these third truths. But thou, O Daniel, shut up the words and seal the book, even to the time of the end. Many shall run to and fro, and knowledge shall be increased. This is prophetic and not to be done in the time of Daniel. Since 1930, the increase of knowledge is so fast and quick, because God promised that before He comes, He will accelerate the time. He will fast track the time, because His coming is not slow. His coming is very fast and very quick, at a twinkling of an eye. And this is happening since the beginning of 2030. Many shall run to and fro, and knowledge shall be increased. As we can remember and be reminded that man has developed their space program and sent a spaceship to the outer space, and this is the wonders and the beauty of the knowledge of the Lord given into men. A genuine and true scientist will end up knowing God. So if a scientist desire to know God, then a great amount of wisdom and knowledge will be given and imparted to them, so that they will reach a height of understanding on the miraculous. And the good news is that in Jesus we have the wisdom, that in Jesus we have the understanding, that in Jesus we have all the knowledge. Perhaps we are not scientific in our approaches in light. But because of the goodness of the Lord, we are able to use, for instance, I am able to use the medium of television, the medium of the website of the computer, I am able to use it. So I am not wasting this increased knowledge. And always be reminded that it is faithfulness that God desires to see from our heart. And God is watching in 2 Chronicles 16:9, because travel is increased. For the eyes of the Lord run to and fro. If traveling is running through to and fro, the eyes of the Lord run to and fro also throughout the whole earth. So people travel increased all throughout the whole earth, but also the eyes of the Lord. So in the natural, people travel a lot. In the supernatural, the eyes of the Lord travel a lot. And the intention of the heart, the motive of the heart of God is to show himself strong in the behalf of them whose heart is perfect toward him. So what is the content of this verse? To show himself strong in the behalf of them whose heart is perfect toward him. So if you desire the accompanying presence of God, if you desire that God will go with you, then desire to have a lively relationship with him. Desire to have a one-on-one conversation with him. Desire to be in love with him every day. That is the way to perfection. So it is relationship. So God will show him very strong to those people who trust him, to those people who depend on him. Because it is a blessed position to trust in God alone, to continue on depending on God alone. Then life will be different. There will be a clear distinction between those who serve the Lord and those who don't serve the Lord. Jesus is coming soon, and let his glory cover your life. You are saved now because you confess that Jesus is Lord of your life. And it is wise to save souls. So continue on saving souls so that God will have an opportunity and a privilege to bless you with all the necessary provision and supply for your desire to save many people. In closing, I challenge you to shine. To shine in your life on this earth. And in Daniel 12:3, desire to shine, you receive salvation, then desire to shine. Daniel 12:3, and they that be wise shall shine as the brightness of the firmament, and they that turn many to righteousness as the stars forever and ever. So again, God's heart, God's goodness is that he don't want that any should perish. Let us be one with God. Let us bring Jesus Christ to many people. Let us save souls, and you will shine as the brightness of the firmament, meaning that God will elevate you, that God will lift you up, that God will exalt you, and that your righteousness will be visible. It will be clear, much clearer than the sunlight, and it will be forever and ever. So let us pray. Father, thank you so much that your glory has made me to proclaim the message. And I pray that everyone who received Jesus Christ receives salvation, and that it is not only for himself, but for many others that you desire for them to carry the message. Receive all the honor and the glory in Jesus Christ's name. Amen.
Jesus is Jehovah.
You have the power to decree.
Amen. Ba yung gabi na walang pag-aalinlangan na ikay tatanggap ng kagalingan ng ibang uri ng sakit o karamdaman niyan?